Thank you. Repeat the Hare Krishna, meditate upon the Hare Krishna, and then will not be any need at all for a separate endeavor to cultivate any type. We may become confused in a dilemma of one issue, and that is that what is described in Shastra and what Śrīla Jīva Swamīpāda has written in his commentary upon this verse. Both are true, it must be true. But it seems that they are at odds with each other, that there is a contradiction.
Ram Vidlan from
Krishna, 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 Krishna. Oh. कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिसे नमो जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण कृष्ण कृष्ण
We are very fortunate today to have come to this most auspicious place, Sri Dandabhanga, the place where Lord Nityananda Prabhu broke the sannyas danda of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu as they were coming from Navadvip Dham and proceeding to Jagannath Puri Dham. So this establishment here that you see, this ashram, it has been founded by the by Srila Gaur Govinda Goswami Maharaj.
Yay!
Srila Gaur Govinda Goswami Maharaj! And his very faithful followers, disciples, whom we are in the presence of today, Sri Satyanandan Prabhu, who is standing next to me here, he is actually the first disciple of Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj. And when Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj was dispatched, actually sent to Bhubaneswar by our Srila Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj to establish a center, then he came to one place here in Bhubaneswar where we will be going today. And at that place, it was all jungles at the time. And actually there were many dacoits. It was a dangerous place. And at that time, Satyanandan Prabhu met Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj. And from his earliest days of doing very intense austerities in his preaching, Satyanandan Prabhu assisted Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj. And it's very well-known fact that he had a bicycle, and Gaur Govinda Maharaj would sit on the back of his bicycle and he would ride him here and there and take him for his preaching engagements. Sri Satyanandan Prabhu ki jai. So he is very knowledgeable and learned about this place and all of the Bhubaneswar pastime places of Mahaprabhu, having heard from the lotus lips of Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj. So we're requesting him that he'll shower this nectar upon us today and inform us about the pure transcendental nature of this sacred place. Hare Krishna.
My exceeding grateful thanks at the lotus feet of our dear Maharaj. And I would beg apology because, to be true to my heart, I am just a fable, a candle before the midday bright sun. You all are Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis. If in the process of making some presentation, if I commit any offense, kindly excuse me, because I am an offender by nature, an ignorant fool. Well, as I am directed by Maharaj, I am begging the mercy of Guru and Krishna to very precisely present something on this great auspicious site that we all are gathered today. But at the presence of so many learned sannyasis, I don't want to go to tattva because it is very deep and immeasurable. It is supreme in all respect. That's why I beg just to make a factual presentation of this great site. You know, in 1486, where from you get the factual descriptions, you can refer to not only Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, also Kanhai Khuntia and Govinda Das, other two very intimate and confidential associates of Sriman Mahaprabhu, those who have written Mahabhava Prakash and Sri Chaitanya Chakra, and also in a book called Gaura Krishna Daya, written by His Divine Grace Sri Srimad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada Ji Maharaj, you will get the descriptions about this great pastime of Sriman Mahaprabhu over here. Well, as Maharaj has explained, Mahaprabhu, in association with Lord Nityananda Prabhu and other associates on his way to Sri Jagannath Puri, reached here on the Ekadasi day. It is stated in Shastra, in the month of Phalguna, in the bright fortnight, the Ekadasi Mahaprabhu reached just across the river. Then he ferried across this river called Bhargavi. About the glories of Bhargavi, you can get some description in glimpse in Srimad Bhagavatam 12th canto. But you will get elaborate description in Murari Gupta's Gorcha. He glorified Bhargavi in such a way that none of us can imagine. So he ferried across the sacred river Bhargavi, which is believed to be the manifestation of Ganga, and spent all the Ekadasi over here, where we all are assembled. In through ecstatic, you know, Sankirtan, Krishna Sankirtan and Jai Jagannath, he spent the night, and it is stated he was greeted on his arrival by Maharshi Bhrigumuni. Maharshi Bhrigumuni is a popular name for all the devotees, one who has compiled Bhrigu Sanhita. It is said that in the words of Acharya, that like Bharadwaja, kept on awaiting to get the darshan of the divine lotus feet of Marjada Purushottama, Bhagavan Sri Ramchandra. In a similar way, Bhrigumuni, who was also the seer of the truth, could know that the supreme Tattva Govinda Sri Krishna, in form of Sri Krishna Chaitanya, will come here. So he took the good advantage of this, and as per the description of Shastra, no sooner Srimad Mahaprabhu arrived the holy land, his sacred feet have been washed by Maharshi Bhrigu, and he drank that water, sprinkles over his head, and then Mahaprabhu spent all the Ekadasi day over here. And you know, this place is surrounded by many ancient shrines, those who have, dotted with great spiritual values. You can get the description also, for instance, Kapateswar Mahadev, which is not very far away. You can get the description in Skanda Purana and also in Valmiki Ramayana, that how Lord Sivaji has been established in the name of Kapateswara by Marjada Purushottama Bhagavan Sri Ramchandra. Nearby, you can also visit a site called Guhaka Pali. You know Guhaka, the friend of the Supreme Lord Sri Ramchandra from tribal origin, tribal chief. How he was lamenting from the Vigraha Guhaka, you can see how the tears rolled down from his eyebox, seeing Supreme Mother Sitadevi is just lying on a stone. That you can also see. You can also see Dandavanga Gopinath just across the river after the great Dandavanga pastime has taken place. How Maharaj Pratap Rudradev, the devotee king, in order to witness this, to commemorate the great pastime of the Supreme Lord, established the temple of Dandavanga Gopinath, that you can see. And if you can further move towards your right, you will come across Ganga Narayan Jiu. Wherever you excavate the soil over here, on the bank of Bhargavi, you will get a number of Ganga Narayana Vigraha. Then, at the center you will find, here at our back, is the, you know, Barahi, the one manifestation of Durga Devi. It is believed that she holds the Parshu of Lord Parshuram. Then, the personal deities of Bhrigumuni are still worshipped. Sitaram Lakshman, Bharat, you can see that still worshipped. And if you proceed further across the main road, you will come across another shrine of great Shaivite importance, that is called Buddha Linga Patna, where Sivalingam is automatically expanding. As per the description of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Sriman Mahaprabhu paid visit to both Kapateswar Mahadev and Buddha Linga Patna as well. But anyway, I am coming back to the great pastime. As per the description of Shastra, this way Sriman Mahaprabhu spent ecstatically throughout the day and night in Hari Kirtan. So in the next dawn, that is in the dawn of Dwadasi, Mahaprabhu expressed his desire to visit Kapateswar Mahadeva, because as Sri Ramchandra he established Kapateswar Mahadeva. That's a beautiful description regarding Kapateswar Mahadeva in Skanda Purana, but it is time consuming to present here, so I am just touching its external side. Anyway, while Mahaprabhu proceeded to Kapateswar Mahadeva, he handed over his danda to Lord Nityananda Prabhu, and taking the advantage of Mahaprabhu's physical absence, Lord Nityananda Prabhu broke the danda, the staff, into three pieces and put it in the water. That's all described in Shastra, and the Acharyas have explained that Lord Nityananda Prabhu broke the staff of Sriman Mahaprabhu because there was no need for Sriman Mahaprabhu to hold the danda in either way of consideration. Mayavadi danda has to be rejected, even Vaishnava danda. That symbolically represent the complete control over kaya, mano and bakya, the oars of the body, mind and speech. So one who reaches the state of Paramahansa, he has surpassed the state to hold the danda. Because Paramahansa, Hansa the swan, it has got a nature gifted quality. If you offer it milk mixed with water, it can only extract milk, leaving aside the water. So similarly, a Paramahansa always remains undisturbed and deeply immersed in Krishna Pramat all the time. So for Paramahansa, there is no need to hold the danda, and what to speak of Mahaprabhu, who is the unlimited supreme absolute truth, Krishna himself. So this is the popular narration, and it is a very, very 100% correct, because Acharya have written, but there is a hidden cause. You know, like the advent of Sriman Mahaprabhu is to introduce Hari Sankirtan. Kali Yuga Dharma Haya Hari Sankirtana Hetadartha Abhatinna Sri Sachinandan. Bol Sri Sachinandan Gaur Hari Ki. So this is the popular cause of Mahaprabhu advent. But he had a deeper cause. Sri Radha Pranaya Mahima Kidrusavanava. You all know, you all are devotees. And so to experience Radharani's love towards Krishna and the happiness he used to derive, to get the taste of that, Mahaprabhu. Similarly, though this is the popular narrations about Dandabhanga pastime, but there's a much deeper cause for which the crest jewel among Vaishnava, Kaviraj Srila Krishnadas Goswami, has written, Dandabhanga lilai parama gabhir taha bujhe jana pade bhakti hai bhi. This Dandabhanga pastime is supremely deep. Only one, he who is absolutely surrendered onto that divine lotus feet of Sriman Mahaprabhu and Lord Nityananda Prabhu, in their heart of heart, this can be revealed. You can find in Lochandas Thakur's works that Mahaprabhu and Lokanath Swami, yes, Mahaprabhu is addressing to his danda and saying that, oh danda, when I was in form of Marjada Purushottam Sri Ramchandra, you are with me as my bow and arrow, and in my supreme form, original form, Lila Purushottam form of Krishna, you are there at my hand as flute. Now I am sannyasi, still you are not leaving me. You are in form of the danda. But Mahaprabhu also explained elsewhere that I will remain here in form of my danda, because you know, if you just look to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya Sachitanya Astakam, Durjana Karma Sakhandana Dandam Tang Pranamani Sri Sachitanaya. So Mahaprabhu remains here in form of his danda in order to sever the inconceivable Krishna prema. So as per the description of Shastra, when one comes to dham, there may be many contradictory, many opposite elements and environment one may have to come across in the arrangement of Kali Yuga. But a sober devotee, surpassing all these difficulties, those who remain in the dham with great heart and keep continuing in their services and get themselves immersed in Krishna Prema and Krishna Sankirtan, will definitely get the supreme destination, that is Krishna Prema, that Parampara. So these are not the saying of mental concussion of any ignorant fool like this downtrodden who is also than a worm in the stool. But these are all the description of Shastra, every detail. So actually, I don't want to take more of your time, but I will tell this situation of the sacred land is in between Ganga and Jamuna. Who declared Dandabhanga as Jamuna? The river Dandabhanga, before the great pastime of Sriman Mahaprabhu had taken place, was known as Kanchanagi. But after this Dandabhanga pastime has taken place, it came to be known as Dandabhanga. And Mahaprabhu, as you see even in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, in every Krishna Janmashtami, he used to have ecstatic Sankirtan, Mahajamuna Snana, on the bank of Jamuna at Mangalaghat, declaring this is the manifestation of Jamuna. And this is Ganga. Wherever you dig, you get the deities of Ganga, Narayan, and there is a Mahaganga Mela takes place, popularly known as Baruni Snana, where hundreds of thousands of devotees and pilgrims from across India and outside do gather. So in between Ganga and Jamuna is the sacred land. And you know, one thing I just put an end to my so-called presentation because I'm an ignorant fool thing. You just notice the word used by the great crest jewel among Vaishnava, Kaviraj Srila Krishnadas Goswami. Dandabhanga lila ei parama gavir, taha bujhe janapade bhakti hai dhir. I think as a layman, nowhere in any shastra relating to any pastime of the Supreme Lord, you can find the use of both the words parama and dhira together, excepting Dandabhanga lila. That itself shows the immeasurable depth of this lila bhumi. Like you say parama, Ishwara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam or Jnanam Parama Vihate Satyam Param Dhimai, the very first look of Srimad Bhagavatam. Or you can say Dhirastatra Na Muheti Na Sochati Na Kanchati Gita. But together this Parama and Dhira, both the words are used only in context with this Dham. So I don't want to take more of your time. Once again I would express my deep grateful thanks at the lotus feet of sannyasis and the devotees, Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis. And please excuse me if I have committed any mistake in my process of presentation. Hare Krishna, Jai Jagannath. Jai Srila Gaura Govinda Swami Guru Maharaj ki. Jai Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Narayan Maharaj ki. Jai Srila Haridas and Babaji Maharaj ki. Jai Samasta Upasthita Sannyasi Vrinda ki. Jai Samasta Vaishnava Vaishnavi Vrinda ki. Jai Sri Srimad Abhay Charanarvinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj ki. Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda ki. Sri Sri Dandabhanga Dham ki. Sri Sri Dandabhanga Lila ki. Gaur Premanande.
Shiva temple, pretty loud here. Okay, I'm getting a view inside the Shiva temple. It's similar to the Jagannath Mandir, I think. Quite nice. Not extraordinary. Nearly there. I'm just gonna do a little pan and see how it goes. That's the entrance dome. Best I can get from here. See if I can get a closer look. Shiva Dome again. Just gonna get a zoom up on the big dome. Thank you.
So, this is a very holy place, Bhuvaneshwar Kshetra, it's this cross, diameter. So here is more than 10 years in Shivalingam. Here is Pati Tirthas. Pati Tirthas are covered by Shivalingam. Two crosses are covered by Shivalingam, and one cross is covered by one transcendental mango tree. Ekam, so this place also known as Ekam. So one very big mango tree is there. We cannot, that person who has transcendental vision can see. So Lingaraj is very interesting teaching. So 500 years ago, Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu came to this place performing kirtan with all his associates and ended to perform sankirtan in front of Lingaraj Mahadev. So Lingaraj is known as Harihara. So very interesting, when you look on the top of the Lingaraj temple, you'll find the deity of Vishnu always has a chakra, the deity of Mahadev has a trishul. But on this temple you'll see both, chakra and trishul together. Normally the temples of Vishnu have Garuda, and the temples of Mahadev have Shiva's Kali and Nanda. But here you'll see both Garuda and Nanda together. Why? Because this deity is known as Harihara. Combined incarnation of Hari and Hara. Hari means Vishnu, Hara means Mahadev. So here, the pujaris offer the boga to Vishnu and to Mahadev both. So therefore, when Mahadev is here, even though normally a Vaishnava will not take a sannyasa for Shiva, that might be true because this is, if you worship Mahadev with the feeling of being a Vaishnava, then Mahadev will accept that Buddha. If you worship Mahadev as a separate thing from another one, then you can sannyasa will not take that Buddha. So very interestingly, before they used to offer the boga, first to Ananta Vasudev, because Lord Shiva Kishadev is Ananta. So Lord Shiva, he always chants the Sankarsan mantra, and around his arms and neck he has snakes representing Ananta Dev. So previously the pujaris would take them, offer the boga to Ananta Vasudev, and they would take it off to him.
This is a side view of the Vishnu temple. Best I can get, there's no rooftops nearby, so it's one off. Just near the dirt, the Shiva temple, which is just down the road about 400 meters. That's the best view I can get of it. Let me see if I can zoom in. Okay, it's Bindu Sarovya. Take another good look at it. All the hand carvings of the stone, or the sandstone. Close up of the hand work they do. Thousands of years for the last. practice.
Who is that? Is that
one of my shackles. All these steel pillars are bars are holding the temple together because it's so old. It should last a much longer time. From a distance it looks like bamboo, like we're just painting it, but we're not. They're holding it together.
This is holiday.
अनाथ वासुदेव वासुदेव अनाथ होते हैं बनेगा वासुदेव होते हैं छोटे करना
Remember, I'm not supposed to be doing that.
Rasananda Prabhu. Ji,
what is this place?
This is
Mukeshwar. This is Mukeshwar. I think that's how you say it. Another hand carved temple. Come by hand. Is it good? The temple. What's the name of this temple?
I haven't heard actually.
I'll find it out in a second. Run your mouth now. I don't need to know. Anyway, there's a cave in here, if that helps. And it's near that mark, and I'll get the name of it over here in a second. Nice temple. And there's lots of bats inside, and it really stinks. Really bad. Let's not put that on. Very extraordinary. Hand carved. Bloody. Sorry about that, guys. Some of the stone wall carvings. Let's see, there's like some weird two-legged giant chicken. About to crush an elephant. Must be a baby elephant. Some Naga queens here. They carve all around the temple areas like this. This one just happens to be the best condition I can find. You can see the snakes around there, the hoods. And see there's a Naga body. Some sort of Naga
This kunda is called Gauri Kunda.
Acha, okay, very good. What?